What happens if you eat moldy bread? Have you ever taken a bite of bread and noticed a fuzzy green spot? Or maybe you have some bread in the pantry with a few spots of mold, but you'd rather just cut off the mold and use the rest of the bread so you don't have to go to the store. If so, you've probably wondered if it's safe to eat moldy bread or any other food with a spot of mold in it. The short answer is no. Moldy bread is not safe to eat, even if you cut off the moldy parts. That's because mold can produce toxins that can make you very sick. In this video, we'll take a closer look at what happens to your body if you eat moldy bread. We'll also discuss some tips on how to prevent mold growth in the first place and why you shouldn't just cut the mold off bread and eat the rest of it. Here are some of the things that can happen to your body if you eat moldy bread. Number one, food poisoning. Moldy bread can cause food poisoning by producing toxins called mycotoxins. Mycotoxins are harmful substances that can cause a variety of health problems, including nausea, vomiting, diarrhea, abdominal cramps, headache, fever, and dehydration. In severe cases, mycotoxins can even damage the liver, kidneys, and nervous system. Some of the most common mycotoxins found in moldy bread include aflatoxins, which are some of the most potent and dangerous mycotoxins known to science. They can cause cancer, liver damage, and immune system suppression. Ochratoxins, which are harmful to the liver and kidneys. Ochratoxins are associated with a risk of kidney cancer in rats, mice, and humans. Fumonisins. Fumonisins can cause nausea, vomiting, diarrhea, and abdominal pain. They can also damage the liver, kidneys, and nervous system. The amount of mycotoxins produced in moldy bread will vary depending on the type of mold, the amount of time the bread has been moldy, and the storage conditions. However, even a small amount of mycotoxin can be harmful. People who are at an increased risk of food poisoning from moldy bread include pregnant women, because mycotoxins can cross the placenta and harm the developing fetus, infants and young children, because they have weaker immune systems and are therefore more susceptible to food poisoning, older adults who also have weaker immune systems and are more likely to have chronic health conditions that can make them more susceptible to food poisoning, and people with weakened immune systems, like those with cancer or maybe HIV or AIDS. Number two, allergic reactions. Moldy bread can cause allergic reactions in people who are sensitive to mold. Mold allergies are one of the most common types of allergies affecting millions of people worldwide. When a person with a mold allergy eats moldy bread, their immune system overreacts to the mold proteins. This can trigger a variety of allergic reactions, including skin reactions like hives, eczema, and rash, respiratory problems like sneezing, coughing, wheezing, and even difficulty breathing, digestive problems like nausea, vomiting, diarrhea, and abdominal pain, or even anaphylaxis, a severe and very life-threatening allergic reaction. The severity of an allergic reaction to moldy bread can vary from person to person. Some people may experience only mild symptoms, such as runny nose or itchy eyes, but others may experience more severe symptoms, such as anaphylaxis. Number three, respiratory problems. Moldy bread can cause respiratory problems in people who are sensitive to mold. Mold spores are tiny particles that can float in the air and be inhaled into the lungs. When mold spores are inhaled, they can irritate the airways and cause a variety of respiratory problems, including allergic rhinitis, hay fever, which involves sneezing, runny nose, itchy eyes, and congestion, asthma attacks, which involve wheezing, shortness of breath, and chest tightness, chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, also known as COPD, which is a long-term lung disease that makes it difficult to breathe, or allergic bronchopulmonary aspergillosis, ABPA, a rare lung disease caused by an allergic reaction to the aspergillus mold. People with weakened immune systems are more likely to experience severe respiratory problems from moldy bread. This includes people with HIV, AIDS, cancer, and organ transplant patients. In addition to the respiratory problems listed above, moldy bread can also cause other health problems, such as pneumonia, an infection in the lungs, bronchitis, an inflammation of the airways, hypersensitivity pneumonitis, an inflammation of the lungs caused by an allergic reaction to inhaled substances such as mold spores, or even mycotoxicosis, a poisoning caused by exposure to mycotoxins, which are toxins produced by mold. If you experience any respiratory problems after eating moldy bread, it is important to see a doctor. They can diagnose the cause of your symptoms and recommend appropriate treatment. And if that's not enough to convince you to not eat moldy bread, here are a few more interesting facts about moldy bread and respiratory problems. Moldy bread can contain a variety of different types of mold, like we discussed earlier. Some of the most common types of mold found in moldy bread include Aspergillus, Cladosporium, Penicillium, and Rhizopus. Mold spores can be very small as 2 to 3 microns in diameter. That's tiny, and it means you could easily inhale the mold spores without even knowing it. This means that they can easily be inhaled into your lungs. Mold spores can also be very light. This means that they can easily stay suspended in the air for long periods of time. People with asthma are more likely to experience respiratory problems from moldy bread. This is because their airways are already irritated and inflamed. Number 4, weakened immune system. Moldy bread can cause a weakened immune system by producing the toxins we mentioned earlier called mycotoxins. Mycotoxins can damage white blood cells, which are responsible for fighting infection. When white blood cells are damaged, the body is less able to defend itself against infection. In addition to damaging white blood cells, mycotoxins can also suppress the production of antibodies. Antibodies are proteins that help the body fight off specific infection. When an antibody production is suppressed, the body is more susceptible to infection. People with weakened immune systems are at an increased risk of developing serious infections from even minor exposures to moldy bread. These infections can include pneumonia, bronchitis, and meningitis. Here are some other ways moldy bread could lead to a weakened immune system. Mycotoxins can also damage other parts of the immune system, such as the spleen and the thymus. The spleen is an organ that helps to filter the blood and remove harmful substances. The thymus is an organ that helps to develop white blood cells. The thymus is often absent in adults or it's very small, but this could definitely affect kids for sure. Mycotoxins can also interfere with the production of cytokines. Cytokines are signaling molecules that help to coordinate the immune response. People with HIV and AIDS are particularly vulnerable to the effect of mycotoxins. This is because HIV and AIDS already weaken the immune system. Children are also more susceptible to the effects of mycotoxins than adults. This is because their immune systems are still developing. Pregnant women should also avoid exposure to mycotoxins. This is because mycotoxins, as we mentioned earlier, can cross the placenta and harm the developing fetus. Now, to prevent mold growth in the first place, be sure to store bread in a cool, dry place. If you see any mold on your bread, throw it away immediately. Even if you cut off the moldy parts of the bread, there still may be mycotoxins present in the rest of the bread. And remember, the mold spores are super tiny, so you may not be able to see them all. Mycotoxins can be heat stable, which means that they are not destroyed by cooking. This means that even if you cook the bread, the mycotoxins may still be present. It is best to err on the side of caution and throw away any bread or food that has mold on it. This will help to protect you from the risk of food poisoning and other health problems. So stay healthy, and thanks for watching.